Hello my makeup family, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me for today's video where I am lip swatching, talking and discussing about Lisa Aldridge's lip products, over 20 plus of them that I own in my collection. I'll be swatching them all out for you, so I hope you find this helpful if you're around my skin colouring and also have olive undertones. And I hope that you find the discussion around the different formulas and the different products and their colourings useful as well when you're making your purchasing decisions. If you'd like me to do this for any other brand or products, let me know in the comments down below and I will look into it for you. Do subscribe so you don't miss those kind of videos. And if you're interested in this makeup that I have on my face at the moment, a tutorial will be on all short form content platforms. Links for my TikTok and Instagram are in the description box down below. Without further ado, I hope you find this video useful. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below and enjoy. So this is Velvet Fawn applied on my lips. I always pair it with a bit more of a deeper lip liner, and this is MAC's Whirl, which has a very similar pinky undertone but still leaning more neutral. And the reason I always pair it with a lip liner is because without a lip liner, I find that this shade washes me out. And with a lip liner, it creates a lot more balance. This is actually my second tube of Fawn because I've completely finished one bullet lipstick of Fawn. I absolutely love the shade. It's so work appropriate. It's very good for those high glam days where you need a neutral look, but still something really classy and glam on the lip. So here is Muse, which has been very used by me. I actually need to buy a new one soon as well. But I paired it with the Muse lip liner, which is formulated to be slightly deeper than her lipsticks. They make a perfect pairing, and this lip liner would actually work really well with Velvet Fawn as well. The difference between Muse and Fawn is that there's much more of an opaque mauvey base coming through with Muse, particularly on my lip colouring. It has quite that mauvey undertone to it anyway, and this is one of those lipsticks that, again, I pull out on an everyday basis because it just is so everyday friendly. Particularly with any type of eyeshadow look, it's not going to overtake or compete with anything else that you may have going on with your makeup. And this is the shade Velvet Affair applied on my lips. As you can see, compared to Fawn and Muse, this has much more of a neutral base. There's a lot less pink or mauve in the undertone of Affair, which makes it highly wearable for any look that you do that may have a lot of warmth to it or a lot of cool to it, because Affair generally tends to sit right slap bang in the middle of cool and warm, and it's very, very easily adaptable to lots of different types of looks. In this try on, I haven't done any lip liner with Affair because it is one of those shades that you can just apply and do on the run, which makes it highly versatile for traveling with, and an excellent shade when you're in the office for reapplying. The other thing about Affair is that it does really well with deep dark lip liners, so you can create gorgeous ombre effects, and I think it truly is a staple in my Lisa Aldridge collection. For those of you that aren't looking for a red on an everyday basis and aren't looking for a berry on an everyday basis, but want something that's kind of in between those and is still wearable for every day but also can elevate looks, I think that Velvet Blush is definitely going to be a winner for you. This is such a sophisticated shade and it's very interesting to look at, especially on different skin colorings as well. It's one of those shades where it has berry, it has red, and it has neutral in, and neither of those colors are the winning competitor of those three shades, which makes it highly versatile. I paired it today with the blush lip liner from Lisa Aldridge, and again, it makes a perfect pairing with her lipsticks. Mm-hmm. Here you have the shade Velvet Beauty. Velvet Beauty is one of those shades that comes out every single transition period from winter into spring, and it follows me throughout the summer period as well. It's a pink, but it has a neutral base to it, which makes it so wearable and extremely fresh for the spring and the summer. In today's look, I paired it with Pinky Swear Lip Liner from e.l.f. Cosmetics, and then I just applied this on top, and I think it's just so beautiful, fun, and flirty. Velvet Carnival is a truly bold, confident, and very, very fun color. It's true to its name of Carnival. It has undertones of purple and vibrant fuchsia in there. And this is a shade that if I'm going on holiday, it's coming with me. When we have those 4 weeks of sunshine in the UK where it hits above 20 degrees and everybody is happy, this is a shade that comes out every single summer. I absolutely love this shade. I think it's so much fun. This is Velvet Bloom, one of Lisa Eldridge's newest shades. It came out as a limited edition shade in 2023 and it is beautiful. It definitely encompasses blooming flowers, etc. And it's one of the shades that I'm yet to explore more with more complicated looks, but it's definitely an easy lip colour to pair with lots of different looks because it doesn't lean too red or too pink. It's a nice sort of in the middle shade with red and pink. This is Rainbow Spill. Again, it's one of those shades that comes out when I go on holiday or when it's the summertime and the sun is beaming. It is a very fun electric coral and it's a shade that really picks up my skin colouring and just adds so much vibrancy to a look. This is Skyscraper Rose. It's a beautiful, wearable, brighter pink within Lisa Eldridge's range. It's not as muted as Velvet Bloom, but it's not as bright and electric as a shade such as Carnival. It's right in between the two, which makes it a wearable spring, summer, or all year round rose shade. This is the shade Velvet Cinnabar. Cinnabar is a warm, muted orangey brown. It's such an interesting colour and it works so well with warmer eyeshadow looks and just warmer makeup in general. It's a shade that I pull for in the autumn for sure. And in today's look, I've paired it with MAC Spice, which makes a great pairing with Velvet Cinnabar. A matte chocolate brown with a blue undertone, a sophisticated and exquisitely interesting shade from Lisa Eldridge. Velvet Decade is a dark chocolate with a cool undertone, making it so easy and versatile to pair with cool tone looks and also warmer tone looks. It actually made it into my makeup favorites of 2023, and for good reason, because it looks fabulous. This is the shade Velvet Midnight, applied as a bit of a stain on my lips. It's actually a shade that my sister has adopted into her collection. It fits perfectly with her aesthetic because she has much more of a smokier and grungier look to her. And Velvet Decade and Midnight both work perfectly with the look she's trying to achieve. So this is Midnight as a stain. And this is Midnight applied to full opacity. I think it's a stunning lipstick. And although it's not one that I'd pull for on an everyday basis, I think, again, if you're going for a particular look or you have a particular aesthetic, Velvet Midnight is definitely one that you can't find everywhere because it's got those complex neutral browns mixed in with a gorgeous purple. This is Velvet Morning, a shade that is not for the faint-hearted. It's a gorgeous electric orange red, and it is one that is going to suit anybody with a warmer undertone perfectly. When I go more golden olive in the summer, this is a shade that pairs so beautifully with more complex looks and also just mascara and simpler everyday looks. It is a beautiful orange electric red. If you're looking for a shade that's not as neutral brown leaning as Velvet Cinnabar or as electric as Velvet Morning, I think that Velvet Dragon is going to be the shade that you are looking for. It has a wonderful neutral undertone that really grounds the orange warmth of the shade, but overall it's a beautiful, slightly vibrant orange shade that is gorgeous. Again, it's going to look fabulous on warmer skin colorings. And it's a shade that I pull out in the summer when I want a bit of an orange hint, but I don't want it to be too electric like Velvet Morning. This is Velvet Ribbon, a classic blue-toned red, and it is fabulous. I absolutely love Ribbon. I have it in the lip gloss form and I adore it. I have it in the velvet form, I adore it, and I think it's such a classic and beautiful shade. You can see all of those blue tones come out, and I just think it brings so much vibrancy and life to my undertone. For this look, I actually paired Velvet Ribbon with its corresponding lip liner, and again, a true classic blue red, it'll never go out of style. And finally for the Velvet Reds, this is Jazz. Jazz is the one that started it all for me. I absolutely fell in love with the formula and the color, which is a deep, dark vintage red. She actually has another shade called Velvet Duchess, which is on my wish list, and it's almost as if Velvet Ribbon and Velvet Jazz had a baby and created a gothic, vampy, reddy blue shade. It's absolutely stunning, but Jazz and Ribbon together can create, I think, a similar effect to Velvet Duchess, but either way, both Ribbon and Jazz are stunning red shades, and this shade gives vintage vibes every single time that I wear it. It is still to this day a favorite of mine. So we're into the Lucent territory, and the first one that I wanted to demo is Go Lightly. Go Lightly is actually a very well loved but discontinued shade. It's one of the first Lucents that she released where people went absolutely wild, because it's definitely a unique shade that doesn't necessarily fit every single undertone in traditional makeup lines. And what Lisa did with Go Lightly was produce a shade that was so beautiful and fit with so many different undertones that people went wild. They lost their minds. But I believe that she discontinued it because of a formulation issue with this specific color. And she released a new shade called, I think, Kitten Mischief, which is very, very, very similar to Go Lightly. But I think it's just missing this like electric soft peach that it has running through its undertones. I have definitely kept my Go Lightly, and whilst it can be a tricky shade to apply because it kind of like takes off on itself and it has a bit of like patchiness sometimes, but when my lips are in good condition, it looks absolutely fine. It's a shade that I just find is so unique and well formulated to my skin coloring that I just never want to get rid of the shade. I even bought my mom, I think, this specific shade in the lip gloss form because she fell in love with this lipstick and tried to take it from me. But I'm very generous with my makeup collection, but this is the one lipstick that I will give to nobody else apart from myself, because it is a truly unique, genius invention by Lisa Eldridge. Calling everybody with a olive undertone that sits around my complexion range, this is Je Ne Sais Quoi. It is such an underrated Lucent shade. It is absolutely beautiful and it works so well with an olive undertone. And again, when I get to that warm olive range in the summertime, the way that this pops and just brings out the warmth in my skin coloring is actually so underrated. It's so beautiful, and I think this is one of my favorite lucents that Lisa Aldridge has done. It's quite difficult to choose between her lucents because I don't have nearly as large as the range that I have in the Velvets, but I find that the colors that she's produced in the lucents are really spectacular. They're so easy to wear and they just elevate skin tones so perfectly. And je ne sais quoi, such a delicious summertime shade. One of the things that I love about Lisa's Lucent line is it's very forgiving with application. Because it's a sheerer and a more creamier, lightweight formula than the Velvets, you can basically apply these as you go, as you've seen when I was doing this shade, Love of My Life, which was one of the first lucents that I tried from Lisa Aldridge. As you can see, Love of My Life is a beautiful soft pink with blue undertones. It's such a fresh feminine color and it's so fun. It's very underrated, I think, and it's a shade that when I was applying, I was like, why have I not pulled this out in the longest time? It's definitely a shade that is going to be on my radar for spring and summer this year. And again, that beautiful, comfortable, lucent formula, you can't go wrong with Love of My Life. This is the shade Le Mepris, and this is actually a shade that I'm going to do multiple looks with to show you how versatile it is. This is Le Mepris applied on my lips with no lip liner and nothing else on the lips. It definitely looks like maybe just like a tinted balm, but actually I find that this is one of the most versatile lucents in Lisa's line, especially of the ones that I own. So I'm going to show you a couple of ways that I wear Le Mepris, and it really elevates any neutral looks. This is Le Mepris paired with a beige lip liner. I applied the lip liner all over my lips and then I applied this on top. This is Velvet Affair applied with Le Mepris on top, providing a beautiful, neutral, soft, beigey brown look. And finally, this is my favourite lip liner from e.l.f., which is Dark Koa, mixed with Le Mepris in the middle. As you can see, Le Mepris is a highly versatile shade, and it's definitely one that is fun to play with, particularly with darker lip liners or darker lip colours. This is Myth in the Gloss Embrace formula from Lisa Aldridge. It's a stunning blue-based berry red, and I love this shade. I think it's so sophisticated and classy, and it looks amazing as a lip gloss. This is Ribbon as a Gloss Embrace, and I think with all the glossy high shine that goes on with the shade as a gloss, it is so captivating. It's truly just a juicy, sophisticated, and quite a fun shade as a gloss. This is Silent Sun, and I'm not gonna lie, when I first got Silent Sun, I was disappointed. I found that it didn't have as much of those interesting gold particles unless I was looking up close in a mirror. However, now that I've had some time to play with Silent Sun, I have to say it's probably, especially over the last 6 months, one of my most used gloss embrace shades. And that's because it's kind of like Le Mepris, where you're having to pair it with lip liners or over the top of other lipsticks or even over the top of other lip glosses to really get its full potential and use. And I actually find it quite an easy shade to pull for because it doesn't really distract what's happening underneath, but it adds a nice high shine and a tiny little bit of gold sparkle. This is a shade I would recommend to anybody looking for a very subtle gloss or somebody who wants a topper shade to lipsticks and lip liners. Finally, we have Beauty in the Gloss Embrace formula. This is a beautiful, fun shade, especially for spring and summer. And I actually end up using Beauty in its gloss form a lot more in the summer than I do in the spring. And that's because the wind is less, so lip gloss doesn't get caught in my hair as much. And also because it's just super easy to pull out, apply, and take it with me and apply on the go. I think this is a fun shade, both in the Velvet formula and in the lip gloss formula. And I actually think the gloss form of Beauty brings a little bit more fun and flirtiness to the shade, and it is a little bit brighter than the Velvet formula. And there you have it. That is a comprehensive overview, a deep dive into the Lisa Aldridge lip products that I own. I do hope you find this useful when making your purchasing decisions, wish lists, and just having a good look into someone else's makeup stash. Let me know your thoughts about this video down below. Stay safe, everybody, and I shall catch you in the next one.